All right, welcome to SilverC Review. This is going to be a little awkward. It's way colder than I thought it was going to be, so I'm going to leave my hood up and everything. I knew it was supposed to be rainy today, but I didn't know it was supposed to be this cold. I didn't look at the temperature. So, here we are. I'm sitting on kind of a dock right now. I wanted it to be cool and you could see the bluffs and stuff behind me, but number one, it's kind of far away, which I'll probably do a video kayaking over there, so that way you'll be able to see them closer, but not really working out, and it's kind of misting. I'm a little bit worried about my camera, but hopefully it survives, so I'm just going to go with it. And also, the wind is pretty heavy, and I can't seem to get my paper to stick very well, so I'm going to have to reach up and mess with it a couple times. Speaking of. So anyways, I'm going to do this podcast, video, whatever you want to call it, probably until December. And then after that, if I don't have anyone that seems to like it or anything like that, then I'll probably stop. I think by that point, it'll have given me enough time to do everything I want to do with it. To run the experiment, to have tried something new, and like I said, it's not costing me anything, so it's not like a burden on me at all. It just costs me time, and I think after a year of doing it, I'll have had my fun, and if no one else cares, then I'm going to stop caring at that point as well. So that's my timeline. I'm trying to shorten the bullet points, so that way I felt like the last video I was staring at the paper and reading it a lot because some of my bullet points were just 3 cents long. And that's fine for like a description, but I'm trying to shorten them down, and that way I can extend on what I want to say just based on what's there instead of actually having reading it. Plus, it was so long, I was losing my spot, so I was like skipping over stuff, and so trying to work on that. Hopefully I'm in the frame. I tested it, but it just looks so weird. It looks like it's looking down. We'll see. I am kind of leaning back, so hopefully that helps. Oh, last time I finally boosted the audio on the video part, and then I forgot to boost the audio on the audio part, like the MP3 version of it for the podcast websites. So hopefully I'll get that corrected this next time. I'll actually boost both of them. It's like I can never win. And you'll probably be able to hear my voice. As cold it is, cold as it is, I can't really talk very well. I kind of considered doing an anime section, but I mean, I'm not getting any feedback right now, so I don't really know what kind of audience I'll have, so I don't know if they would like anime, and it's kind of, the mist is kind of picking up. And a lot of this stuff I'll probably have to re-say if I do start to get an audience. I'll have to restate some of this stuff because I doubt everyone's going to go back and rewatch all this. But I can easily do an anime section is what I'm trying to get at. I watch a lot of anime, both movies and TV series, so that might be a future section if it's warranted. Hey, look, the wind got it to where I need it. I watched Gotham by Gaslight. And it's an animated movie, and Batman, of course. And it was okay. It was like it was him versus Jack the Ripper. And it was an interesting take on the Batman series, because it was kind of like back in the old days. Not a huge fan of it. I mean, I'll still add it to my collection. I'd say I give it a 5 out of 10. I'm kind of biased on cartoon movies for some reason. Like, even though I'm not a huge fan of them, I still usually add at least superhero movies to my collection. Which I'll explain my collection later on. The other movie I watched was Wonder, and 6 out of 10. It was really good. I liked it. They didn't go too far into the sympathy area, and they still kept it a lot of dynamics, showing that he's not the only one that was suffering, and it was really neat. And I really liked the quote at the very end. It said, "Be kind, for everyone you meet is fighting a hard battle." And I thought that was incredible. That's something that a lot of people forget, and all it takes is just a smile sometimes as you're passing someone by, and they might be having the worst day ever, and that could turn things around for them. So you just never know what other people are going through, and more often than not, it's could be worse than you or as bad as you, so just be nice to people. And the other movie is Daddy's Home 2. give it a 4 out of 10. It was just as good as the, or it was the same as the first one, not just as good. I mean, it's worth watching, but not something that I'd add to my collection, and not something I'd watch a second time or anything like that. So, we're going to go over the Cloverfield Paradox, and hopefully this is in the frame. Maybe down here, I don't know. I'm going to give it a 5 out of 10. It wasn't too bad. I heard from someone that it was supposed to be the worst of the three, and I didn't actually know 10 Cloverfield Lane was part of the series. Like, I could have sworn that I read somewhere that 10 Cloverfield Lane was not related to Cloverfield, and I guess it is, actually, and I didn't know this was a prequel either, so going into it, my take on everything was very weird. I was extremely lost to start off with, because, like I said, I didn't know, I thought this was after the found footage version of it, and I didn't understand why they were in space, or why they had this technology, and even then, it seemed like they were a little bit more advanced than us, and from what I can remember from Cloverfield, the found footage seemed like it was present day, so it was weird that they were on a spaceship, especially now that I know it's a prequel. Which I guess it wasn't that far ahead of the other one, but still, it doesn't feel like we're at that level of advancement. And they also don't explain, that I noticed, unless I just missed it, where the technology came from. Like, I know why they're up there and why they're doing what they were trying to do to try to solve the energy crisis and stuff, but it never said where it came from. I guess maybe that's part of the paradox, or maybe I just missed it. That one part where he said the worms are missing, and then that dude burst open and all the worms, and he said, well, there's the worms. That stole the words right out of my mouth. As soon as that happened, I was like, hey, that's where the worms went, and that's exactly what he said. So I thought that was pretty good. It seemed like a general alien thriller, space thriller, and I mean, it's not a bad thing. There was nothing really that stood out a whole lot to me, but it was good for an alien thriller, I guess. Good enough to warrant a 5 out of 10. Not good enough to make it into my collection, though. I thought the alternate reality was kind of confusing at first. I mean, I understand the movie is called Paradox, and that kind of explains part of it, but when it started off, I was like, why do we have an alternate reality? And I know they kind of explained it. Well, they explained why it happened, I guess, but they don't really explain the rules of it because they don't know the rules of it, and they don't ever find out the rules of it, and that's, I'm kind of, on a lot of movies, I like them to explain a lot of stuff. Like, I can take some stuff for granted, or not for granted, but I can accept some stuff without explanation, but a lot of it, I like explanations for, some background, a little bit. It doesn't have to be super intense or anything like that, just a little bit of background. Oh, I'm going to have to read this one, because it's long, but I'm going to give my acceptance speech, even though I'm not accepting anything, but here it goes. I'd like to thank my spine for always having my back, my legs for always supporting me, my heart for keeping me pumped, my fingers because I can always count on them, my eyes for seeing things through, my ears for always hearing me out, and my butt for sticking around through some of the worst crap, and I'd also like to thank my arms for always being by my side. Unlike that, guys! Yeah. I thought that was weird. And it never explains it either, why the wall was, like, sucking him up, and all of a sudden why his arm was missing, and why it was sentient, and it helped him out. Like, it just kind of drops it. I mean, it's definitely never going to go back and explain something like that, so I thought that was kind of, it was interesting watching it, but I didn't like it because it didn't explain it, or I don't know. Seemed like there were several things in this movie that just were left unexplained, and I don't think they're going to find an explanation since we've already seen the movie that comes after this. It really annoys me in space movies when stuff freezes instantly, because that's not what happens. I mean, that's been disproven many times. Yes, it's really cold in space, but heat does not transfer from your body in space like it does here on Earth. I mean, if you were in water that was as cold, I know it'd be frozen, but if you were in water as cold as in space, then yes, you would almost flash freeze. But out there, like, it can't transfer. It can only transfer through, what is it, some sort of radiation. So it makes me mad when people are in space and they just instantly freeze. I mean, yeah, you'll die within like 30 seconds without a spacesuit and stuff, but you won't just freeze like that. Also, water, and that's with our body. Water in space, because of the pressure, boils and then freezes. So that explosion, when it all flash froze, what should have happened was it should have boiled to the point to where it became a mist and then freeze. So you'd have this like frozen ice crystal mist floating around instead of this big, I know it's not as cool looking, but I don't know. It seems like every single space movie does that, and it annoys me every time. Also, the explosion, I mean, only the oxygen. I know it showed oxygen there, and that's why it exploded, but for it to push the explosion out like that, I'm not sure. Like, I'll write that one off. That one's kind of iffy. I feel like explosion in space would look a lot different than it did, but it wasn't too bad, too far out there, so I'll write that one off. Yeah, at the ending I realized it was the prequel when I saw the ship coming down. Boy, this is not very good. And it never explained that worm dude, why he was hearing voices or what was going on with his eye or anything like that. Like, it was just a very, they kind of went out on a limb with their alternate reality and then didn't explain. Like, I'm not saying they have to come up front and explain it, but at least find some information to say why some of the stuff is going on the way it is. But, is this, I don't know if this is going to be their last movie, or if they've got a plan, or, I mean, I feel like this is kind of like the X-Men, how they are jumping around, and it's hard to tell where you're at, and I mean, it's, now it's easy to tell that they were all in the same universe, I guess, all three movies, but like I said, I'm pretty sure when 10 Cloverfield Lane came out, there were a lot of websites saying it was not even related to Cloverfield. And, because I had to have seen it somewhere. So, it's weird how no one can seem to tell what's going on with these movies. But, oh, now my paper's wet. That's even worse. So it's like curling. Yeah, I liked it better than 10 Cloverfield Lane and Cloverfield. So, it's kind of funny because the person I was listening to said it was going to be the worst of the three, and it was the best for me, but that's because I like action-type movies. We're going to go on to the movie recommendation. I will right here, and the wind is picking up. Yay! This is going to be batteries not included, and it's going to be in my hand for a little bit because it's cold now, and I didn't say the name earlier. It is from 1987, and it is a very heartwarming movie. It's by Steven Spielberg, so it's an awesome movie, of course. I highly recommend it. And let me read the description here. Frank and Faye are an elderly couple living in a depressed part of town. They run a diner and apartment building, but a property developer wants them to sell the apartment. When they refuse, their diner is vandalized. They are then, however, aided by a mysterious flying saucers, which help them rebuild the diner and fight back. And these little flying saucers are so cute. They've got little eyeball-looking things, and the way they move around and function, and I don't think they ever really talked, but they can make, like, noises and stuff. And think if you've ever seen the movie Gremlins, it's like a robotic version of Gremlins, but much, much smaller. So, for some reason, it seems like smaller things are cuter. And there's one that, like, walks around, and they're falling and stuff, and they're goofy, but they're helping out, and it's also these older people, so it's kind of, it's neat because they're so accepting, and the older people, all the people that live in the apartment are nice, and it's just, it's like a good versus evil, but it's kind of a goofy way to go about it. And, I think I just said everything about it. Oh yeah, this was way before WALL-E and, Star Wars, so BB-8. Yeah, people love those robots. You'll really love these robots. They are neat little guys. So check it out. Batteries not included. And we're going to go on to quotes. Yay, I'm almost dying. I'm actually not all that cold, but it's rather annoying that my paper got so wet now. It's just like, maybe there's, I wonder if there's a better way to make bullet points. I don't know. Maybe I'll figure that out one day. If I ever had any feedback. Let's see. What do you call a cow with a twitch? Beef jerky! Wow, that was really low. That's weird. It sounds low. I hope the volume looks okay on the video. Maybe the wind. How much does it cost for pirates to get their ears pierced? A buccaneer! Yay! Can you hear the wind blowing in my paper? And the quote is going to be, "What you do speaks so loudly I can't hear a word you say." And it's kind of just a different take on actions speak louder than words. And I like this one better because it's almost like saying, I can't even hear anything that you're saying because of what you're doing. And that's one of the truest things I have found in life is people can say whatever they want, but if their actions don't reflect it, I mean, that's like people apologize and stuff, but the best apology is a changed action. Like, if you're, you can say you're sorry a million times, and I may have mentioned this on that Beatrice at Dinner movie, but that was why I was so annoyed at that movie, is because she'd apologize, and then do the same thing, and that's just not a fun thing to deal with, so don't be that way. And also watch for it, like, you can see right through people just by their actions. And the other one, very similar to that, is, I don't trust words, and I sometimes question actions, but I never doubt a pattern. And, I mean, even then, sometimes people will act accordingly just to get something from you, and it may only be once or twice, but if you see a pattern of them just constantly trying to get stuff from you, or being mean to, maybe it's to mean to other people. I mean, I've seen online a lot of people say that they judge harshly on how people treat waiters, and I mean, I worked in retail for 10 years, so I know all about customer service and how poorly people can be treated and how stupid some customers can be. And it's just, a lot of people are fake, and if you just watch them. You don't have to listen to them or anything like that. Just watch them, and you can tell exactly what's going on. And it'll really improve your life. So, that's going to be it for now. The next movie will be Maze Runner, The Death Cure. And I'm just going to put all my links and all that stuff in the description to my Twitter and my Facebook and all that, my podcast, so that way I don't have to keep saying it. But I will always say my Flickr account, which is SilverC_review. And I'd rather people go to it than any of these other places, besides, of course, the podcast websites, just because photography is one of my main passions in life, and it's what I get the most feedback on, so I think people could really enjoy some of the pictures I post on there. Like I said, I just post one a day, be mostly nature shots, something cute, something cool to look at, and it's actually starting to rain now, so anyways, check them out. Take care.